Friends, I am Colonel D.S. Cheema. I want to share with you something very sensitive, but at the same time I think it is very important to know that. I was there in Delhi on 31st October 1984. Since I have first-hand information, I wish to share certain facts with you. It is a fact of life that no Sikh can ever forget the tragedy of June 5 and 6. 1984, when the Golden Temple was attacked with infantry, armor and artillery. I was posted to Military College of Electronics and Mechanical Engineering at Secunderabad near Hyderabad in 1982. As a matter of fact, I had gone for a course, 4 months course. And after the course, I was found suitable to be retained there as a directing staff. And so I was posted there as a major for 4 years. It was in 1984 that I became a lieutenant colonel. One of my responsibilities there as directing staff in the Faculty of Industrial Engineering was the training and development of senior officers of Corps of EME. I was to take them out for project studies, carry out the studies in major organizations, make presentation to the organization. This was a part of training of the senior officers. In 1984, beginning of October, I was given a team of 4 senior officers course program, 2 lieutenant colonels and 2 majors. And I was asked to carry out the study of streamlining of Army headquarters at Delhi. So we were in Delhi finalizing the project study. It was, you know, we had already carried out the audit of the entire system as it is done. After that, the findings of the study and final recommendation was being prepared. During the last few days, I got another idea and I wanted to collect some more information to support our recommendations. I requested is because that officer who was undergoing the course, he was 2 years my senior. I requested him to go and get some information from the nearby unit. He came back after 10 minutes and I thought that since he was a known shirker, I thought he's come back because he did not want to go and do the work. So when I asked him why had he come back, and he broke the news that Prime Minister Indira Gandhi had been shot. Everyone was stunned, we were shocked, and of course everything was topsy-turvy. We didn't know what to do. And you see, then in the evening, we were told that the bars will not open and the officers' mess, even dinner, may not be available. And on TV, the whole scene was being shown and the bullet-ridden body of Indira Gandhi was being screened on all kind of channels, and all of us were watching that. That particular day, one of my friends who stayed in Delhi, he was posted in Delhi and he stayed in one of the localities of Delhi. He had promised to come and pick me up and take me for dinner. Since this terrible incident had happened, I thought that he wouldn't be coming. But after some time, I saw his ambassador car entering the officer's mess, and he and his wife were there to take me along. I went with them, and en route, about 10 kilometers which we traveled, I saw a lot of people gathering and shouting with mashals and tires being burnt. It was about 7:38 in the evening. People had already started doing all kind of mischief, was already on. Every culvert, every bridge, every square crossing, I saw a lot of people gathered and people shouting slogans against Sikhs and whatnot. When I reached his home, I did not expect the kind of thing which I saw. There were a lot of crowd gathered around the television, and people were, some of them, the ladies were crying. The moment they saw me, because I could make out that I was the only one wearing a turban, one old lady rushed to me and started putting her hand on my body and started saying all kind of Punjabi abuses. I was taken aback. I did not expect this kind of treatment at the house of my friend. I told my friend that let's get back. I cannot stay here because I was worried about my security, because everyone was shouting and, you know, sobbing and looking at me with hatred. Then my friend hugged that old lady and told her, "Mummy, what is this man's kazoo? Why are you trying to abuse him?" Then I realized that that old lady was the mother of my friend. There was no question of any dinner, etc. So I requested them to take me back to the mess, and after about 15-20 minutes, we started our journey back. Again, en route on a particular bridge, I saw so many people gathered and shouted and, you know, trying to wave to stop the vehicle. But my friend drove on and he did not stop the vehicle. We reached the mess. Next day, I received a phone call from my friend at 11:30. He said, "You are a very lucky man." He told me that when they went back, he and his wife, the vehicle was stopped for 2 hours, and they were asked to produce the sick man who was traveling in their vehicle. He was able to, since he was a local, and he showed his identity card, and he was able to get out of the trouble. But he told me that had they any idea that you were there, you would have been lynched there and then. Anyway, the things were bad. There was nothing to do. We couldn't do anything about our project further. And I was able to speak to my wife. I had a telephone at my residence in Secunderabad, and she told me that the commandant's wife had taken her to the local Gurdwara to pray for our safety. We got the message from our commandant at NCME that we should get back, and not by train but by air. So, being the directing staff or in charge of the team, I was responsible for making all the arrangements to take them back safe. So I took 2-3 more officers along with me, and we went to the Indian Airlines office in Connaught Place. We were in uniform, but we were surprised that because there were 3 of us who were with turbans, the attitude of the staff was hostile. They were not wanting to help us at all. We had to put the weight of our uniform and create a bit of scene to be able to get 5 seats booked to Hyderabad on 5th of November. When we reached the airport also, I could make out that their attitude toward us, especially the people who were with turbans on, was terrible. They were rude to us, they won't talk to us properly though we were in uniform, and somehow we managed to get back. The point I wish to make is that was the time when the entire Sikh community was targeted as if everyone is a terrorist. Everyone was a terrorist. That is how the feeling got traveled throughout. And as you know, at least 3,500 innocent Sikhs were killed in Delhi, and perhaps more than 10,000 or maybe 15,000 all over India. To my mind, it is the greatest tragedy to have been visited upon India after the partition. And of course, the Babri Masjid demolition in 1992 is another, along with this 1984 riots and genocide of Sikhs, is another black spot on the not so fair face of India. It is unfortunate, but it is true that the police and the politician, they were a party to all that happened. Delhi High Court gave a scathing kind of indictment, and it said that a majority of the perpetrators of these horrific mass crimes enjoyed political patronage and were aided by an indifferent law enforcement agency. So much to speak about the fair name of our police. Thank you.